Hi, my name is Rick Sanchez. I'm with a company called Tractor Tip, and what we have for sale here today is an oldie but goodie. This is a Komatsu WA180-1. I'm pretty familiar with these machines because I worked for Komatsu for 20 years. This machine was, and others like it, like the PC200 and whatnot. These are the machines that really got Komatsu entrenched in the heavy construction mining business. I mean, this isn't a mining machine, but so we're going to talk a little bit about the mechanics of this particular machine, the first clip, the operating specs in the second, and we'll run it in the third. Price on a new machine like this these days is about $125,000. This machine currently has 1,923 hours showing on the hour meter, but that's not, I don't think that's what the correct hours are. As far as manufacturers go, Komatsu's number two in the world of heavy construction mining. They're second only to Cat. They're pretty ubiquitous out there. The weight of this particular machine is 20,600 pounds. The widest point is actually this bucket right here at 7'11". Now if you were to take the bucket off, it's got a quick coupler on it. The width of these tires is 8 inches if you put the bucket parallel with the forks. The highest point is the top of that cabin, 10'4". The transportation length from the front of this cutting edge all the way to the back is 22 feet. Comparable machines are like a Cat 924 or an older K621 or maybe a Volvo L50. As far as the history of this unit goes, like most of the machines we purchase, it's an original owner Dallas, Texas machine with no rust. We're far enough south and 300 miles from the ocean, so the only salt we see is the salt on our kitchen tables. We don't clear snow or anything like that. It comes from a large, well-organized contractor here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area who had a comprehensive maintenance program that rivals some of the best I've seen. We, as well as our customers, have been happy with all the machines we've purchased from these guys, and it should be said that before I buy any machine, my mechanics thoroughly inspect it first, and then I inspect it before I write a check. I'm not in the habit of buying junk. So again, this is an original owner machine. As far as the engine goes, this is a Komatsu S6D-102. It's a 110 gross horsepower. It's got a 45-gallon tank, 45-gallon diesel tank. That'll give you about 12 to 14 hours depending on your application. Go ahead and show you the other side of the engine there. All of the fluid levels are currently where they should be. Everything's mechanically sound on this machine. There's no leaks. Everything works. The transmission runs through all the gears in forward and reverse without hesitation. Top speed is 21 miles an hour in forward, 21 in reverse. Brakes stop it on a dime. As far as options go, this machine has got a quick coupler with it. And it's got this bucket, obviously, and a set of forks. Tires are probably about 10%. There's no cuts or gashes in the tires. They're 17.525s. They're radial, so I'd probably average them maybe 10 to 15%. The hydraulics are strong. There's no cracks or welds anywhere in the equipment. Show you the work equipment here. You can see there's never been any kind of cracks or welds. This is original paint. All of the pins and bushings are relatively tight. This articulation joint has very little deflection, pretty good shape. If you see a little wet there, that's actually water. We rinsed it off just a second ago, so. The cutting edge over here is probably about 45%. It's already been turned. As far as this bucket goes, it's 7 foot, again, it's 7 foot, 11 inches wide. It's 3.5 foot tall. And it's 28 inches deep. It's about a 2.25 yard bucket. The hinge pin height, if you were loading into a dumpster, is 11 foot 8 inches. The breakout force of this loader is about 21,000 pounds, and the static tip load of this loader is about 20,000 pounds. And simply stated, the lifting capacity of this loader is limited by its static tip load. And that's the definition of that is that the hydraulics on this machine are so powerful that the machine will actually tip forward before the hydraulics give out. So the lifting capacity is limited more by the weight of the unit than its hydraulics. Couldn't stop it. Okay, so these are the forks of the machine. This carriage height is 42 inches tall. The carriage width from here to here is 5 feet, and the tines themselves are 5 foot tines. And this carriage assembly goes, I mean this fork assembly goes on that WA180. We're gonna run it in the next. Okay, so this next video is just gonna show that the all these gauges work. That torque converter gauge isn't gonna move too much because we're not gonna get it hot enough, so. This is the inside of the cab, pretty much. This is actually your coupler release right here. We've also got other loaders. We got a couple of 621s. We've got two 938s over here. Here's the other 621. We've got a 928 back there. All of these loaders are equipped with a quick couple disconnect forks and a bucket. So that's something to keep in mind.